Hello everyone. In last video, we have discussed about the theory of a successive disintegration and the radioactivity series. So, in theory of a successive disintegration, we have learned that radioactivity is a nuclear phenomenon in which all the natural occurring radioactive nuclei are disintegrated successfully to the another nuclei to form a stable end product at the chain decay. So, we are considering a parent nucleide A, which undergoes disintegration to form a daughter nucleide B, which is unstable, and it further undergoes disintegration to form a stable end product C. So, this is given by the A tends to B tends to C. From the radioactive decay equation, where N, which is equal to N naught e to the power minus lambda t. From theory of a successive disintegration, we come across the final equation where N2, which is equal to N0 lambda 1 divided by lambda 2 minus lambda 1 exponential of e to the power minus lambda 1 t minus e to the power minus lambda 2 t. This is a concept about the theory of a successive disintegration. Now we shall see about the radioactive series. Radioactive series is classified into four groups. They are uranium series, actinium series, thorium series, and neptunium series. Uranium series is also known as 4N plus 1 series, which has an integral multiple of 4 and plus 1 elements. And similarly, actinium series is also known as 4N plus 3 series, where it has a mass integral multiple of 4N plus 3. And similarly, thorium series is also known as 4N series, which has a mass integral multiple of 4. Similarly, neptunium series is also known as 4N plus series, which has a mass integral multiple of 4N plus 1 series. Now, we shall discuss about the topic of radioactive equilibrium and radiocarbon dating. Radioactive equilibrium. During the successive radioactive disintegration, when the number of atoms of the each member of the radioactive series become constant, it is said to be a radioactive equilibrium with its parent nuclei. At this stage, the rate at which the new atoms are formed is equal to the rate at which the atom of the nucleus are disintegrated. So, this radioactive equilibrium is also classified into two groups. They are permanent equilibrium and transient equilibrium. Now we shall discuss about the permanent equilibrium. In case the two element series, when half life of the parent element is very long compared to the daughter nuclei, where lambda 2 is very much greater than lambda 1. Therefore, lambda 2 minus lambda 1 is proportional to lambda 2, where lambda 1 is proportional to 0, and e to the power minus lambda 1 t, which is equal to 1. Now we are considering the equation of N2, which is equal to lambda 1 N0 divided by N2 minus N1 exponential of e to the power lambda 1 t minus e to the power minus lambda 2 t. It is a theory of a radioactive disintegration final expression. So this for this equation, we are applying the above condition. So, equation can be written as N2, which is equal to lambda 1 N0 divided by lambda 2 1 minus e to the power minus lambda 2 by t. Therefore, a very long time e to the power minus lambda 2 t become negligible. So, the equation can be written as N2, which is equal to lambda 1 N0 divided by lambda 2. So, again rearranging this equation, so we get an equation as lambda 1 N0, which is equal to lambda 2 N2. But N0 can be written as N1, since a mean life T1 of the parent nucleide element is very large. Therefore, lambda 1 N1, which is equal to lambda 2 N2. This implies the rate of formation and the rate of disintegration of the daughter nucleide become equal. This type of equilibrium reached by the daughter nucleide with the parent nucleide is said to be a permanent equilibrium. The another name for the permanent equilibrium is a scalar equilibrium. Next one, topic, transient equilibrium. Here we are considering the two cases where lambda 2 is greater than lambda 1 and lambda 2 is lesser than lambda 1. Now we are considering the first case, lambda 2 is greater than lambda 1. The parent element sorry, the planet nuclide has a longer half-life than the daughter nuclide, but lambda 1 is not small enough to be ignored. Therefore, the term e to the power minus lambda 2 t approaches 0 faster than e to the power minus lambda 1 t. So, again we are considering the equation of a theory of a disintegration n2 which is equal to lambda 1 n0 divided by lambda 2 minus lambda 1 e to the power minus lambda 1 t minus e to the power minus lambda 2 t. So, again applying the above condition, so we get a final expression as n2 divided by n1 which is equal to lambda 1 divided by lambda 2 minus lambda 1. This implies n2 divided by n1 is a constant. This type of equilibrium is called as a transient equilibrium, in which both the parent and daughter nuclei disintegrate with the half-life period of the parent nuclei. Now we are considering the second case where lambda 2 is lesser than lambda 1. Then the term e to the power minus lambda 1 t vanishes faster. Considering the equation n2 which is equal to lambda 1 n0 divided by lambda 2 minus lambda 1 e to the power minus lambda 1 t minus e to the power minus lambda 2 t. It is also an equation of a theory of a successive disintegration where we are applying the above condition. We get a final expression as lambda 1 n0 divided by lambda 2 minus lambda 1 e to the power minus lambda 2 t. In this case, the daughter nuclei decays with its own half-life period. The parent, however, decays much faster, and only daughter is practically left to the decay. In this such cases, radioactive equilibrium is not possible. Now we are discussing about the new topic, radiocarbon dating. Radiocarbon dating is nothing but it is a method of determining the age of a certain biological and geographical up to about 50 years ago with a high degree of an accuracy. The radioisotope carbon-14 and 6 is used in this method. So this radiocarbon dating is used to detect the dating of the bone, wood, plant, etc. When a cosmic rays enter to the Earth atmosphere, collide with the gas atom in the atmosphere, and it produces a secondary cosmic rays in a form of an energetic neutron. This energetic neutron collide with the nitrogen atom and turn them into the carbon-14 atoms. The carbon-14 atoms thus created combining with the oxygen to form a carbon dioxide. The plant absorbs carbon dioxide and incorporated into by its photosynthesis. Carbon-14 entered the body of living organism through air and food. The ratio of carbon-12 to carbon-14 in the air and all the living things are at any given time is nearly constant. There is a small derivation regarding to this concept. It can be discussed in next classes.